In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create this loop made out of geometric shapes. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. We build a structure first, then animate some shapes. The challenge will be to make it a seamless loop. Without any further ado, let's get started. First of all, we create a new comp. Let's name it Tile, because that's what it is. Dimensions 900 by 600 pixels this time, 4 seconds long. Next, we divide it into 6 equal squares. We double click on the rectangle tool to create a new shape. Let's name it Shape 1. No stroke, solid fill. We open the rectangle path property and set the size to 300 by 300 pixels. We open the position property. The position is 150 x and y. We duplicate it and move it down. 150 and 450 pixels. We duplicate the two shapes and move them to the right by adding 300 pixels to x 450 pixels. We duplicate shapes 3 and 4, open the position properties, and again move them to the right, each to x 750 pixels. Alright, let's close all the position properties and change the fill colors. Shape 1, I keep this purple blue. Shape 2, cyan. These 6 shapes are like our background. Shape 3, why not? Cyan as well. We use the color picker. Shape 4, red. And you'll see there's one more purpose. Shape 5, red as well. We use the color picker again. Shape 6, green. I think 4 colors are okay. The more colors we use overall, the harder it is to make the loop seamless. Alright, next we add a circle. With no layer selected, we choose the ellipse tool and double click on it. Fill black this time. The colors are totally up to you, of course. Let's name it Circle 1. We open the ellipse path property and set the size to 600 by 600 pixels. The position 300 pixels x and y. We don't want to see the whole shape, just part of it. Therefore, we add the set matte effect. And take the matte from shape 1. We set a position keyframe at the beginning. At 1 second, we move it to x 600. We duplicate the circle. Change the fill color into cyan, using the color picker. We take the matte from shape 4 and set the position at the beginning to x 0. And then to 300 and 300. Then let's add another shape, a square this time. With no layer selected, we double click on the rectangle tool. Name the shape Square 1. Fill color red this time. We use the color picker again. First of all, let's rotate the shape 45 degrees. We open the rectangle path property and set the size to 424 pixels each. We add the set matte effect again and use shape 2 as matte. The position 0 and 900 at the beginning, we add a keyframe. 0 and 600 and 1 second. Next, we duplicate the circle 1 again. Fill color blue. This time we use shape 5 as matte. The position 900 and 0 at the beginning, 900 and 300 at 1 second. Finally, we duplicate square 1. Fill color, let's leave it red. But we take the matte from shape 6. Position 900 and 300 at the beginning, 900 and 0 at 1 second. Alright, the movements are still linear. It's about animating the shapes first, getting into details later. Let's move on to the next second. We add radial wipe to circle 2. And adjust the position of the wipe center to 300 x and y. We set the transition completion to 50%. Set a keyframe. Press U until we see it in the timeline. The keyframe needs to be at 1 second, actually. Then we set the completion to 75% at 2 seconds. And nothing happens, we set the wipe to counterclockwise. Awesome. Then we select circle 1 and split the layer at 1 second. We take the mat from shape 6 and animate the position. We delete this first keyframe here, 600 and 0 at 1 second, 600 and 300 at 2 seconds. Then we split square 2 at 1 second. We keep the red fill color and use the mat from shape 3. And again, animate the position. Delete the first keyframe, we leave it at 900 and 0 at 1 second, move it to 600 and 0 at 2 seconds. Then we duplicate square 3. This time we change the color to green. We take the mat from shape 1, the position 0 and minus 300. At 2 seconds, 0 and 0. Let's check it out. All we do is basically moving shapes from one square to the next. We already need to think about the end. It needs to look exactly like the start frame. First, let's make sure the square colors are the same. The top left shape 1 needs to be blue, so we simply move the green square 4 to the left, out of the screen. Minus 300 and 0 is the position. If you get these round motion paths like I do, use the Convert Vertex tool and click on the corner point to make them linear. Square 3, let's move it down to 600 and 300. We need to use the Convert Vertex tool again. And then hide it. 900 and 300 is the position. One more click with the Convert Vertex tool. Awesome. Square 1, we move it to the left, to 300 and 600 pixels. We want a linear motion path, of course. And we scale up the X value to around 280% to cover the whole square. The bottom left square needs to be cyan in the end. So we duplicate square 1, set the fill color to cyan. And the start point of the solid to 2 seconds. We open the position property and get rid of the first two keyframes. We set the position to 0 and 900. At 3 seconds to 0 and 600. At 4 seconds to 300 and 600. And don't forget the click with the Convert Vertex tool. Alright, what's next? Square 2 is missing. So we duplicate it, move it to the end. Set the position to 900 and 0 at 3 seconds. 900 and 300 pixels in the end, which is the same position as in the beginning. Next is the blue circle in the upper right corner. Here it is. Let's adjust the endpoint. We duplicate it, move it to the end, start point at 3 seconds. The position is 900 and 0. We delete the second keyframe, cause we use the radial wipe again. We set the wipe center to 900 and 0. Wipe counterclockwise. Transition completion 75% at the beginning. We set a keyframe, 25% at the end. Let's check it out. Well, there's still a lot of weird stuff happening. So, what's next? Yes, this black shape needs to disappear. Let's find the layer. Here it is, circle 4. At 3 seconds, we move the position to X 300 to let it disappear and get rid of the Bezier curves. Awesome, one problem solved. Then there's this blue circle, which suddenly disappears. So we move the endpoint of the layer to 3 seconds. Add a keyframe at 2 seconds. Then at 3 seconds. Oops, one frame missing. We move it down to Y600. Let's see. Almost there. It's just that black circle in the top left corner. So we duplicate the layer from the beginning and move it to the end. Open the position property and basically swap the positions of the two keyframes. Let's see. I don't like that it's moving in and back out. So let's change the position to 300 and 600. That's better. Then we select all layers, press U to see all keyframes. Right-click on one of them to add easy ease to all of them. We open the graph editor to edit the speed graphs and slow down the beginnings and endings even further. Awesome, that's much better. We create a new comp, call it loop, 1920 by 1080 pixels this time, 8 seconds long. Then we add the tile comp. Scale it down to 75%. Go to the Effects and Presets window to add CC Rapid Tile. Expand it in all directions. Let's use checker 180 degrees as tiling. And let's duplicate the comp. And move it to the right in the timeline. Awesome. This is a basic loop made of geometric shapes. To break up this very strict move cycle, you now could start playing with additional shapes. Let's go back into the tile comp, close all these properties here, and add a new round shape. We name it ball. Fill color blue. Let's open the ellipse path property and set the size to 300 pixels. Position at the beginning, 450 and minus 150 pixels. At 6 frames, it hits the edge, 450 and 150 pixels. At 8 frames, it moves up 30 frames. At 10 frames, it hits the ground again. At 13 frames, up again. At 16 frames, it hits the ground again. We set another position keyframe at 1 second. At 32 frames, we move it to the left to hide it again. We slow down the beginning here using the graph editor. A lot in this tutorial was actually improvised on the go and not planned before. Check out the project file to see the final loop. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell, because you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, guys!